Hello everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're going to learn how to install NetBeans 8.2 in Kali Linux. So we have a video which were the first time what we did, let me go CD, I'm gonna go back, I'm gonna show you. You might have a problem after downloading, haven't showed how to download, but anyway, I'm gonna show you how to download. What you do, you go here to your browser, and you go back. I did this, yes, I wanna. So you type in NetBeans download. When you click here, it's gonna take you to this page. When it takes you to this page, it's gonna select your operating system by default. Then you click here, you download whatever you want, but me, I'm gonna download this full. When I click yes, it's gonna pop, give me a pop-up to download. It's gonna come yes. Then you say okay, since I downloaded it already, I don't need to do that, so I'm gonna close that. So but now I know it's in the download folder, so I'm gonna cd to that download folder. Cd to down, no, what's going on in here? I'm gonna cd to downloads, then I say enter. We in downloads, then we're gonna say list. We want to list what is there. What is here is this. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna give change permission to this, because if you don't change permission, it's gonna give you error which says permission denied. So we want to change permissions to 777, which means read, write and execute. So we're gonna say chmod, then we say minus r, then we put 777, then we put our file. Yes, we put this file, which is okay. So here we need a space, then we say enter. Once you click enter, it simply means that's fine. So how do we install? To install is something easy. You're gonna just have to ./, you put your file, this is the file, then you say enter. When you hit enter, it's gonna start the process of installation. It's gonna extract the data and also run the installer what wizard. So wait a bit, it's gonna come and show us what's going on here. Okay. It's taking longer, it shouldn't take that longer, but it's gonna be fine. Just have to be patient. If your computer is a little bit faster, you can see now where it goes. It's already installing. Okay, it's gonna ask you some questions here. You just say next, like the way you install something in Windows, next, and it will ask you all of these questions. Leave it and say next. Don't customize anything, just go next, and it say check for updates, say yes, say install. Which is good. Okay, I'm gonna go and say it's installing, guys, just have to be patient, but we're almost done. shouldn't take that longer. It's 95% on my side. It's almost done, and we are about to finish, guys. Just installing GlassFish server, open source edition 4.1.1. Installation is almost done, guys. Let's be just patient. I did another video previously on how to create install the 8.0.2, but this one is 8.2. That one didn't even finish the installation. We just showed the steps how to do, but this one is 100% full video how to install NetBeans. Plugins are a little bit heavier. I thought it was gonna be that quicker, but now, since you see when I was downloading, I selected that one with everything, so that's why it installed a C#, C++, and everything, PHP. Everything is still going well, guys. Yes, we're done. See, it's gonna tell us that we finish. Say click finish. Yes, we're done with that. Guys, that was the tutorial, and I guess you would like to us to search and start using NetBeans. I'm gonna say NetBeans. I'm gonna search it, and I put it on my favorite, and I'm gonna start NetBeans. See how it's gonna work. I've started it this side. You're gonna see it soon. Yes, that's what we're talking about. Your NetBeans is already working. You can create a new project if you want to. You give it whatever you want to, whatever name you want to, and say next. And after that, then you're gonna start doing what your start your Java programming. Yeah, guys, the application, you can give it any name. You can name it maybe Azania. We're not gonna do much into that. I'm just wanted to show that NetBeans what the NetBeans we installed is 100% working. But other stuff, I think we can see in the next tutorial. If you have something to say or ask about this all NetBeans thing or Java programming, please feel free to put a comment in the comment box below. So here you can see that our Azania package is opened, our Azania class is there, and we can also start executing our code if we can do something. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video. Please don't forget to subscribe or to comment and share.